This is a community-supported legal education channel. Find out how you can support our mission at the links in the description below.
So Bill Murray received an epic cease and desist letter this week, and we should definitely go over what it says and what's going on here. This is posted by Eric Gardner. He says, Bill Murray receives a legal demand from the Doobie Brothers, and it's everything you'd want it to be. Dear Mr. Murray, we're writing on behalf of our clients, the Doobie Brothers. The Doobie Brothers perform and recorded the song, Listen to the Music, which Tom Johnston of the Doobie Brothers wrote. It's a fine song. I know you agree, because you keep using it in ads for your Zero Hucks Given golf shirts. Of course, he's selling them under the brand William Murray, which is funny because I don't think anybody knows him as William Murray. And this is the polo shirt, Zero Hucks Given. Our new Zero Hucks Given pattern is a wink and nod to one of Bill's longtime heroes, Samuel Langhorne Clemens, also known as Mark Twain, and the spirit and nature of his beloved Huckleberry Finn character. This new pattern features elements borrowed from our bunker camo patterns in past collections, background as Huck rafts his way down the mighty Mississippi. We do not wish any reward for this new design, but to know we've done the right thing in bringing this classic to life. It appears to be all sold out, probably in no small part to the publicity that it's received recently, thanks to the rest of this letter. However, given that you haven't paid to use it, the Listen to the Music track, maybe you should change the company name to Zero Bucks Given. We understand that you're running other ads using music from other of our clients. It seems like the only person who uses our clients' music without permission more than you is Donald Trump. This is the part where I'm supposed to cite the United States Copyright Act, excoriate you for not complying with some subparagraph that I'm too lazy to look up, and threaten you with eternal damnation for doing so. But you already earned that with those Garfield movies. And you already know you can't use music in ads without paying for it. We'd almost be okay with it if the shirts weren't so damned ugly. But it is what it is. So in the immortal words of John Paul Sartre, au revoir, golfer, et paye. So that is written by Peter T. Paterno, attorney of King, Holmes, Paterno, and Soriano. And it accomplishes so many more things than just the text. One, it called a lot of attention to the situation. So now everybody who doesn't know who the Doobie Brothers and hasn't played their music is going to go look that up. Everybody who hasn't bought a Bill Murray shirt is now going to buy them. They're completely sold out. This attorney is probably going to get a bunch of publicity, as I just gave them as well, because of this well-written letter. And it shows that attorneys can be fun and don't necessarily have to be so stuffy in their smoking jackets in their law libraries. I think that's a lot of fun. I think that more attorneys should write their cease and desist letters with some kind of style. It should still be appropriate, but it should be fun. And I just thought I would describe that to you and tell you what's going on there. They apparently have responded, offering the ugly golf shirts in return for the rights to use their music in their ads. And who knows, maybe they will strike some kind of a deal. Murray's lawyer responded, saying, first, I would like to compliment you on finding levity in the law at a time when the world and this country certainly could use a laugh. Your client's demand was able to cut through the noise of the current news cycle and remind us how much we all miss live music these days. We would like to confirm that both our firm and the good folks at William Murray Golf are indeed fans of the Doobie Brothers music, which is why we appreciate your firm's choice of taking it to the streets rather than to the courts, which are already overburdened minute by minute with real problems. Your negative comments about the shirt's fashionableness are especially disconcerting to all of us, especially considering 75% of my wardrobe consists of William Murray polos, shorts, and pants. Color me biased, but the consensus on this side of the table is that Bill and the brothers have some of the most clever and creative lifestyle wear available. In the immortal words of Mr. Murray, the more relaxed you are, the better you are at everything. So let's pour one up and unwind. Pour one up? Wouldn't it be pour one out? So let's pour one up and unwind with a listen of the recently released Quadio box set and plan to cross paths at a Doobie Brothers 50th anniversary show in 2021 when some level of normalcy resumes. As your client so aptly stated in this classic song in question, what the people need is a way to make them smile, which both Bill and the Doobies have been doing for decades as world-class entertainers. The lawyer signed off by asking for their shirt sizes so he can happily upgrade their wardrobes. Please provide us with the shirt size for yourself, Tom Johnson, Patrick Simmons, Michael McDonald, and John McPhee, along with which of our clients' shirts you find the least offensive, and we will happily upgrade your wardrobes and hopefully win each of you over as new fans of the brand. At least that's what this fool believes. And they have, here's that letter as well. Our firm represents WM Golf, William Murray Golf. And then they proceed with what I've just said. So that's really interesting. I thought you'd get a kick out of that. So let me know what you think in the comments, and we'll follow up if there's anything to be followed up with there. I have a feeling that there will be some agreement struck between those parties. But they certainly called attention to their brands with that clever lawyering now, didn't they? Are they trying to get away without also offering a licensing fee? Maybe. I doubt that that's actually what's going on there. I think it's just some clever public lawyering because these letters are all published, not only sent to the opposing party, but also published online. So there's some publicity and marketing going on there in the background, if you hadn't figured that out. I guess you pour up a drink before you toss it down. Yeah, I guess. I'm used to the pour one out, but different cultures, different terminologies, I guess. I'm certainly learning that there's a bunch of different terminologies in different cultures. I only just learned that in the UK, ta is short for thanks. Never knew that one. I'm 40 years old, never knew that one. Yeah, I mean, I get it. Like, when you pour it, the glass fills up, so you're pouring it up. You know, also, when you drink something, you pour it out. You pour it out down your gullet, so who knows? And then there's, of course, when someone dies, sometimes you pour one out onto the ground as a remembrance or respect. So there's a couple different ways to phrase that one. Just like in the US, you would have a license, like a liquor license or something. In the UK, you are off license when you have a license. When you're off license in the US, you're off your license. You don't have a license. You're not on your license. When in the UK, if you're off license, you have a license. So it's, you know, they're just some weird terminologies for things. So that's what I've got for you today. Let me do my outro and we'll let you go and get back to your lives. That's our show. Thanks for joining me. I'm Leonard French, your favorite copyright attorney, and this is Lawful Masses, your favorite legal news and education program here on YouTube, also on Floatplane and on Twitch. This is a community-supported legal education channel. Thank you very much to our supporters in the month of September. At the $50 plus level, thank you to Joe Tyson, Wes Delge, Citizen of the Sovereign, John Steele, Gavin Barnard, Evie, Kyle Mudrock, Spirit Bear, Benjamin Hightoff, Steven, Cute Grills in Your Area, Longreach Jones, Goliath Cleric, Ugly Grill, Shiloh T, Rudolph Bescherer Jr., Oscar the Prophet, Jay Dixon, Hot Grills in Your Area, Ammonite, Engie, Torpedon, Brandon Abel, Cassandra Curran, and I-Anal, I Am Not a Lawyer. And thank you to the $5 plus supporters who are scrolling on the screen in front of me and on the LED panel behind me here. I am Leonard French, your favorite copyright attorney. I will see you in the videos that drop. I hope you have a great week. I love you all. Bye.